Hello everyone. So previously we talked about the particle in the infinite square well, a particle under the effect of the harmonic oscillator potential, and also we talked about the free particle. Now we have to make just a quick break before we continue calculating some other potentials to discuss something that are called the bound states and scattering states. So in order to do that, let us now think of the following. So whenever we have a particle that is subject to some potential, now this particle will have some energy and the potential can have many values. So let us now take a look at some cases that are possible. Now, classically, let us just draw some random potential and let me just here make a line that indicates our level of energy. So we have a particle. And this potential can take many forms. If we are talking about classical mechanics, we could think of this just as a mountain, for example. So this potential just would be the gravitational potential. So if our particle does not have enough energy, it will not be able to escape from this pit on the mountain, right? If this has just an energy level that gets up to here, then it can only get as high as its energy. Right, it cannot go any higher because it just does not have enough energy. So at least in classical mechanics, this is what we would call a classically bound state, right? Because the energy here just does not allow it, the particle, to escape, so we call it bound state. Okay, so that is the first case, and that is very important. So basically, whenever the energy is less than this potential, it's going to be, at least in classical mechanics, we call a bound state. It cannot escape. But now let us think of some other configuration of energy, of potential, sorry. So in this case, let us say that we have a potential that goes something like this. Now it still has a turning point, right, which is what we call this point where we already get to the potential gets to the same level as the energy. But now in the direction of minus infinity, there is no limit. So in this case, this isn't really a bound state because our particle can keep moving in this direction. So we can call it here just a scattering state. That's what we call a scattering state, which is basically the contrary. Well, I already wrote it down there, I guess. It's basically the opposite of a bound state, right? The scattering state is the state where the energy can exceed the energy of the potential and thus the particle can escape. So for example, in the case of the hydrogen atom that we will take a look at later, you have a proton and an electron, and the electron is orbiting the proton, and this is what we call a bound state too, right? So when this is already a hydrogen atom, it's going to be stable and it's a bound state, so we know that the electron is not just going to fly away and dissolve this atom, right? It's going to keep being there unless there is some sort of external energy that increases its energy. So those are bound states, and we have encountered them before, although we didn't really give them the name yet. So in the case of the infinite square well, for example, remember our potential function of x, right, was that at x equals 0 and x equals a, we had infinite potential. So in this case, whatever the energy of our particle may have been, it was not going to be enough to escape because we have an infinite potential. So both in the harmonic oscillator and in the infinite square well, we were dealing with bound states. However, when we were talking about the free particle, remember in the case of the free particle, the potential was non-existent. There was no potential. So in that case, this was just a free particle which was then a scattering state, right? So, and as we saw, there were quite many differences between these bound and scattering states, as we saw in the difference of formalism that we had to take between them. Now, so how can we now talk about this maybe a bit more formal in quantum mechanics? Now, what we have to take into consideration is then if the energy is then less than the potential, right, then we could talk about this being a bound state. But it's not just the energy being less than the potential. What we have to take a look at is what happens with the potential as x goes to plus or minus infinity. Because we have to take a look at if at some point this particle is going to be able to escape. And what we also see is that the potential, at least in physically realizable states, has to go to zero as the as x goes to plus or minus infinity, right? As you go increasingly far away from potential, it has to go to zero. So what we're going to get is that whenever we have energies that are lower than zero, we are going to be talking about a bound state. And in the opposite case, when the energy is greater than zero, so this is bound, we'll be talking about scattering states. Now, you might be wondering, which is at least something that happened to me, like, why is it negative energy? I mean, energy is not supposed to be negative. That doesn't really make much sense. But here, what we are just talking about is this is a relative energy, right? It's not just absolute energy. This is going to be regarding the potential that we're dealing with, right? So don't really worry about that. So that is what I wanted to just discuss here, the existence of these bound and scattering states, because we are going to be encountering in quantum mechanics some quite different things that we saw before that we're going to talk to in detail. But as we saw, if we have some potential that is not infinite, right, but it's still greater than our energy, then at least classically this particle cannot escape. So there's a zero chance of finding the particle anywhere in this region or anywhere in this region, right? However, in quantum mechanics, there's a phenomenon which is called quantum tunneling, which allows the particle to tunnel through the potential as long as it is a non-infinite potential, and it will give you a non-zero probability of finding the particle outside of what would be the region where you expect to find it. So that is something that we will now be slowly working towards, and we will in later videos go ahead and prove this phenomenon of quantum tunneling mathematically. So that is it for today. I will see you in the next video.